Hello, and welcome back to my Let's Play of The Binding of Isaac. This is episode 5. This may be the last episode, in fact. I couldn't really sleep last night, so I ended up playing it for quite a while, and I managed to actually beat the game 2 more times, unfortunately not on camera. It was late, so I didn't want to wake anybody up by talking to myself. So the main screen here has changed to now a dead baby with some flies on it and stink lines. And the more important factor here is that I've unlocked ... or the blue baby. As you can see, he's got -1 for health, which means that he's only got spirit hearts, and you don't even have the ability to get more actual hearts. All of your health ups turn into more spirit hearts. And his special spacebar item is a piece of poop. So yeah, pretty useful stuff. So the final challenge now to finish this whole series off will be, can I finish the game with this character? And that will unlock one of the last unlockable items that I haven't gotten. There's still a couple more, but that's the last really difficult one. After that, it's really all just a matter of time. So I've already replaced my piece of poop with a remote control. And I'll use that in a second. Oops, see, I can't take any damage on this, or this is not gonna work out. I played one round with him last night, just for fun, and he made it to about caves 1. Well, he, under my control, made it that far. It's definitely a bit tougher since you just can't pick up any health power-ups, it's all gotta be soul hearts. So, with a bit of luck and some excellent item drops, I think it's quite possible. Just gotta get the right combination of circumstances for that to happen. I should mention, as of the 9th beating of the game, the final boss has changed to be a fetus instead of Mom's Heart, which took substantially more damage to bring down. I had a pretty overpowered Maggie going into that boss fight, and it still took like 5 minutes of just wailing on the heart to bring it down, so... or not heart, but fetus. And instead of spawning the usual enemies from the womb in Womb 2, it starts spawning bosses. Not the most difficult bosses or anything. Like I said, I was a little overpowered, so I tore through most of those too, but if you were not in a position to go that quickly, you could definitely get caught up on each individual boss, and I could see that final boss taking quite a while. I actually had lasers with the highest possible power up, so that's penetrating shots, and it was quite impressive to say the least. I had the money equals power glasses, which allow you to turn the amount of coins you have into an amount of stat upgrades. So as you'll see, I just gained another soul heart, so the health ups that we relied upon are now completely ephemeral. So if I could run into the devil room, that would be really nice. I was really hoping maybe I could trade some of my soul hearts for a nail, because then I'd be able to actually generate my own every so often, and if I could get a nail and a battery, then I would be in great shape. Nickel, that's always good. And I saw that tinted rock, I just don't have any bombs, so nothing I can do about that right now. Couple of gish. Just stay right adjacent to them and they can't do anything to you. Put their heart power up, you see I can't use these. Kick them around. Damage. So basically, if you don't end up getting something good right off the bat, you're pretty much screwed by about the 3rd or 4th level. Come on now. These guys have way too much HP. We have a pill. What do we have? Oh no! Crap, and my analog stick just screwed up. Okay, well that was embarrassing. The tilt on my analog stick on my 360 controller is such that if you accidentally tap it with your thumb, it will not adjust back to dead center, so I end up flying in some direction that I don't intend to. I should probably just turn off the analog stick. Would really be the smart thing to do. And another nickel, so looks like if I can get another key, I really need to be headed into the shop. And I still haven't found any bombs, which isn't good either. Happy to have a brother Bobby along for the ride. More gas. Wonderful. So many flatulent properties these pills can bestow. I guess on the upside, I will always have enough health to go into the mob trap room. Okay, cool. Key and a bomb. Oh, wander into a fly. Whole bunch of grandfather flies. Take them out. And some of these guys. Okay. I would say a good trade-off. And another key. Alright, I'm happy with that room. Even though I took a hit. No bombs. No, no. Okay, gotta make this quick. No more bombs, please. Holy shit. They're everywhere. They're everywhere. Okay, so I'm just about dead. And I pick up a death card. I have enough to make it into the item room, or the shop, rather. So I got a Book of Sin. Yeah. That's gonna spawn some random item every time I use it. Of course, most of the time it's gonna be an item I can't use. So I guess I'm just gonna have to hope I can not die. And I guess I'll check in here, too. $0.03. It'd be cool if they gave me, like, a soul heart or something, but whatevs. And we have famine. So this will probably be the end of this. Really should have used that death card. You know what? This is so short, I'm just gonna start over. I imagine you guys probably don't want to watch a 7-minute video. Especially since that wasn't all that exciting anyway. Maybe we'll get better drops this time. Okay. See, what we need to be focused on here is not so much health power-ups, although I need those, but really things that can generate health. That's what we need. And also things that can give me some boosted power. Because, poop item just doesn't cut it. We've got a tinted rock over here, I see it. But I have no bombs again! So if I can finish the game as the Blue Baby, that should unlock an item called the D6, which allows me to re-roll my items if I'm not happy with them. I'm not sure exactly the circumstances of how that works, whether it's like a spacebar item you spawn with, or who gets it, or if you have to find it somewhere. But still, the ability to re-roll your items seems very cool to me, as it will allow me to kind of wrap up the loose ends that I don't have yet. Balls of Steel, okay, well that's something I could use, so I'm happy about that. Oh, freaking went down into the rock, that doesn't work. Still no bombs. Let's do it. Okay, Monstro and two rogue flies. I bet he's going to shoot blood at me at some point. And slam again. Oh. That really taught him. You'll notice since my health is technically at zero, every room I go into I pee myself. And no, I don't mean the character on the screen, I mean my actual person, I pee myself. Yes, I'm capable of being sarcastic too. My YouTube friend's Anzo was asking me if I was planning on doing any other Let's Plays, and I think I probably am. I think maybe some kind of classic SNES game. I mean, they've probably all been done to death at this point on YouTube, but I think there's something I can still cover out there. I was meaning to replay that game, EVO Search for Eden, at one point. Maybe that's something I can record. Let me know if that's something you guys would like to see. It's a really cool little game. Basically, throughout it, you're creating a sculpted kind of life form and adapting to your environment by spending, like, RPG experience points that you get by eating fish and stuff. And you transcend through all the different states of being, from, you know, being a fish to going on land, reptiles, and then humans, all kinds of crazy stuff. You get to be a dinosaur at some point, which is kind of cool. One of those games that I played it a lot, but I only kind of played the beginning. So I would like to branch out and see where that goes if you stick with it. And then of course there's my all-time favorite SNES game, Super Metroid. I could always play that. Try and do a speedrun or something, but I think everyone under the sun has done one of those by now. Trying to avoid doing something that's going to be like 100 parts, if possible. Had some pretty easy rooms. Can't complain. Health's still looking okay. Definitely use some more bombs, though. Boop. I kind of wonder about the inclusion of that item at all. Like, is it just there to mock you? You start the game with this completely useless item. Like, am I just missing it? Is there something that it is useful for? I mean, I guess I could, like, block a path with it. Oh, this is a good thing to find. All stats up, so I get a speed up, tears up, power up, another health. Yeah, I guess I'm pretty happy with that draw. But again, I really do need to get something that's going to allow me to create my own health. Because this stuff, it's not going to be around for long, I'm pretty sure. I only have 2 cents, so, and no bombs, so I really can't look for the secret room or go to the shop. Or get this tinted rock here. Larry Jr. For the third time on camera, I constipated Larry Jr. Maybe I can get, like, the X-Lax item and feed that to them, and it'll just shit themselves to death. That'd be an embarrassing way to go. Yikes. Now this time I can poop on you. You can't poop on me at all. Haha. At least the regeneration time on that spacebar item is fast. I think it's like the beam, it seems to regenerate about every room or so. Not like I have any use for it, but... range up, and another heart. Oh, devil room. Let's make a deal. Now, awesome. Alright, that's exactly what I wanted. So if I can get that, and then find a battery, I may have a chance. So let's hope for the best. I'm just gonna use this right off the bat, because I could really use every single charge that I get from it. It also lets me break rocks, which is pretty cool. So since I'm in a position where I don't really have bombs, this will allow me to get through the tinted rocks. Ooh, crap, I think I just trapped myself. Oof, barely got out. Oh, no, I didn't. Fly should not be difficult at this stage in the game. The amount of time I put into this... should never get hit by flies anymore. Oh, man. Alright, well at least I know I have a source of health that will eventually show up again. But I really have to keep these hits to a minimum. Unless you're gonna give me a battery in here, which I highly doubt. TNT. Not better than the nail. Not by a long shot. Getting caught on the edges of these little holes here. I'm gonna approach this as if it was a fistula and try and knock out some of the one flies before I split more flies and make everything harder for myself. Okay, cool, some bombs, finally. I still only have 4 cents, though. So I don't want to waste that key just yet until I know that I have another key. In case I run into, like, a treasure chest or something. Wow. Freaking blood dudes. Okay, this is a terrible room. Shouldn't be. But I'm apparently inept. That was way too much damage. Oh, cool. So it actually opened the secret room for me, and I get some money. That's decidedly better than fighting a bunch of crappy mobs. I kind of need money pretty badly, and I think I'm gonna wait. Of course, now I can't go back to it because you have to use a bomb every time you go in. I'm gonna say I'm gonna wait until I know exactly what this floor has to offer me before I go spend any money on it. In case I find another key and then I can check out the shop. Screw that door up. Okay, I need to get on the other end of this wave. There we go. And my nail's up, so that's good news. A little more health. Oh, and I can smash through all of these rocks, so this guy's not going to be... not like he ever was, but he's not going to be very much of a challenge anyway. He's so stupid, he just keeps bombing himself. Try and back away from him and just walk into him. I just keep getting caught up on the edges of all these rocks and objects. At least I have more health now than when I went into that room. Go up. Go up. Well, I didn't have much of a chance there. elements of this game are just kind of random in a way that I don't like. I mean, you don't really have any option but to take damage when there's enemies walking towards you from both sides. If I had maybe, like, a unicorn horn, that would help. I guess if I was fast enough, I could have, like, popped my hanged man and tried to float over the hole, but I don't think I should necessarily have had to use it there. So I've got 6 bombs now, which I didn't expect. Let's try it on this rock here, see what I get. Okay, so we've got a chest. I'm gonna use this and to get a key back innocent. Let's hope I can find the secret room and then maybe I'll have a shot at something worthwhile in the shop. Okay. Could be there, it could be over here on the left. Hope it's this one.
Damn it.
Oh, what the hell am I doing? I already went in the secret room. So I'm just wasting bombs now for no reason. I apologize to my viewers. I'm just gonna go in anyway. Steam sale, I can't use. Key. And 2 cents for a heart that I can't use either. Well, as much as I would like that steam sale, I obviously can't buy it. But now I know. And knowing's half the battle. Two and a half hearts to fight Gertie. At least it's a regular version of Gertie, that's good. Although regular version of Gertie by 10th playthrough still means very aggressive. My nail isn't up. So I don't have a power boost, so I have to kind of whittle it down. And eventually it's going to start very aggressively spawning lots of flies, and probably grandfather flies, and more of those cysts. I'm having trouble concentrating which side I should be on here. Just get over here, back down, get over here, back down, repeat, ad nauseum. Ad infinitum. Ad hominem. Ad blocker. As much as I love the AI in this game, it seems like this is a little exploitive. I guess if you're going for like a perfect run at the game, it's like you have to kind of know this option exists to getting through the bosses or you have no chance. Okay, well I get 1 soul heart back for my troubles. Moving down, caves 2. Let's see if he has any different dreams. No, same stuff, no toilet paper. This is the room that screwed me up last time, and I'm gonna get screwed up again by it, aren't I? It's a really rough spot to have to deal with these horizontal or four-way shots. Okay, I'm using the nail. There's just too much going on in here, I can't risk taking more damage. An arcade, so I should definitely visit that. Judgment, that's the beggar. I want that. Beggar hooks me up. Come on. 4. Key. Don't screw me here, buddy. You've always had my best interests at heart. Okay, compass. That was a lot of money for a compass, but I guess that's good to have. And I get a cent. So what can I do here that would be useful? I have 2 cents. I could use a key. Well, I'll spend my 2 cents on this guy, because he always drops 2 of pretty much whatever I get. Or I get flies. Let's see any bombs. So he's gonna get blown up in a second. not helping me out here today. Give me a pill. Watch, this will be a bad trip. Pretty fly. Okay. I'll take pretty fly. Well, I'm gonna drop another bomb, hope that I get another key or something out of it. 3 cents. That I can't use now. Well, that'll probably come in handy later on. Okay. Calm down, buddy. Gotta get rid of these turrets in the middle or I'm not gonna do very well in this room. Because I can't even dodge. So I'm in a process here of whittling down flies to whittle down the turrets to then eventually get over there and not step on the spikes. Alright. You guys are getting fucked up. At this point, life is so important to me that I think I'm actually going to use a bomb for this. I could have used the Hanged Man, but I feel like that's probably worth hanging on to. Speed and range, so I'm smaller, and I can shoot farther. But I'd rather be hitting for tons of damage. Balance of, do I need to be running around looking for stuff to power up with, or do I just want to try and get through each level? Definitely do need to power up still. Still need a battery pretty bad. Balls of steel, good call. Oh man, I went to try and go down that little alleyway there and I went too fast. Couldn't take the corner. Okay, big guy's down, dropped a key, that's good news. Taking so much stupid damage. I need to be better than that. What's in here? Should I risk it? Yeah. Probably. This is probably a bad idea. Although it could still drop something at the end. The odds are stacked against me, that's for sure. You know, you would think for beating the game 10 times, you'd get rewarded with something that's, like, extra overpowered, but it's quite the opposite. But, you know, the harder the game is, the more accomplishment you feel when you beat it, so there is that. As a huge advocate of Super Meat Boy, I can attest to that formula being 100% true. Otherwise, there would have been no reason for me to bother trying 100% the game twice. Just for that adrenaline rush that you get when you beat the kid. The elevator level gave me the most trouble, the second one. Just couldn't seem to get the timing on the left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right thing. Huh. Cool. Okay. Need to get the timing right so I can get up next to it. there's like a tiny fraction of a second that you get to fire off a couple shots before it shoots back. My nail is up, that's good news. It's like the only thing that's keeping me alive at this point. So I'm just wandering, hoping that I can pull off some kind of a coup or something where I can get a bunch more items, maybe a couple of nickels. Because unless I get a battery, this is going to end badly. Well, I have 3 cents. I don't know why I want to torture myself with knowing what's in there if I can't buy it. Cloud of flies now, that's good news. Come on. I feel like I'm not hitting anything. I mean, this should not be anything that's difficult in any way. Yeah, here I am, going in circles. Damage for nothing. I wonder how many enemies I killed in this room. Must be quite a few. This room again. I hope on this Halloween patch he adds a few more random rooms. That would be kind of cool. I feel like I'm seeing a lot of the same ones a lot of the time. Just some more floor layouts is all. Not that there's too few, really, it's just like... the way this game lends itself to endlessly replaying, it seems like there should be even more. Oh, and that time that my, well, I mentioned in the... I think it was the first episode that I had about 40 hours, I was mistaken on that. My Steam or something was screwed up, and I actually have closer to 20. Not sure why it said 40, or maybe I misread it, or maybe it said something else, but I was under that impression for a while. Still, 20 hours on a game like this, pretty substantial. I mean, this is not like Oblivion, there's not endless landscape terrains to traverse, this is kind of like a dungeon crawler. And if I compared this to playing like Zelda's dungeons or something, playing those for 20 hours, I would think that would make me go insane, but this is quite the opposite. I'm just enjoying it more and more. In fact, the closer I get to having all the items, the more I want to play it to finish out my collection. I'm not sure if that's a good or a bad thing that I just broke that rock. So the rocks are gonna give me somewhere to hide from these hairy, fleshy blocks. If it was a true fistula, it would have teeth in it. I don't see any teeth. It does seem to have some sort of, like, a metal barb holding it together at the beginning, though. Yay, health. Can't believe I'm so apathetic to finding health power-ups. So I can get, for 3 of my soul hearts, I can get a damage up, or I can get 25 cents. So this is a high-risk maneuver here. If I use that, I'm gonna end up with 2 hearts. Well, in an effort to make this video more interesting, I'm going to buy this quarter. And I'm going to really hope that it pays off. And what I mean by pays off is that there's a battery in the shop. now, I'll probably get green. Haha! Called it. Okay, let's not take a hit, because I really don't want to squander any of the little tiny amount of health that I have. And I also don't want to waste any of my money. So every time he hits you, you tend to drop like two or three of your coins, and it seems like you lose a coin somewhere in that equation as well. Come on. Go down, buddy. You're done. There we go. So ironically, if I would have just gone straight in the shop, and hopefully still not taken a hit, I would have ended up in a similar position money-wise, and not had to give up a bunch of my hearts. Well, now I'm in a spot where I should probably be using a little of this. Because I'm actually ahead of the curve on money. Play this about 5 more times. Planet Earth from outer space, covered in so many satellites you can't even see anything inside of them. Okay, well, use a whole bunch of coins there. I have enough left for 2 good items from the shop. And it dawned on me that I didn't ever find the secret room, so I'm gonna waste, hopefully not waste, but use 1 bomb and find it. Awesome. 3 cents. So I hope you guys are digging the suspense, because, 2 hearts, definitely suspenseful. Got excited for a second, I thought I was getting another fly. Wrong kind of fly. Okay, this slot machine giving me shit today. Depths 1. This is where shit goes down. I'm gonna walk into a room full of leapers, and I'm not gonna panic. Although I have every reason to. Because I have flies here to help. Flies will never let you down. Okay, I'm happy with this room. This is a good room. These guys are basically defenseless. Something spawned behind there, I can't really tell what it is. Oh, I guess it was a treasure chest. Cool. So I really want to get at that item room ASAP. Oh, and there's a tinted rock here. I'm gonna hope that I can explode some of these dudes too. Ooh, shitload of items. Only a few of which I can actually partake in. So we're gonna play Ring Around the Rosie here for a while. Feel free to use this time again to go to our other YouTube channel, Complete Geek Radio, and watch some of the awesome clips that I've made. They'll make you laugh. And feel free to post them for your friends too. You want to make your friends laugh, right? They'll think you're cool. Yeah, I wasn't kidding. Like, really go over there. This is still gonna be a while. And leave a comment, too, while you're at it. Cool. Okay, come back now. Sad that in nearly every video there's a point where I'm doing something kind of mindless and repetitive that you can just leave. I value your time more than that. Time is money, and money is power. Or is it knowledge is power? It depends if you're playing Mortal Kombat, I guess. I want this. And by this, I mean whatever this dude wants to drop for me, because sometimes he gives batteries. And if you don't remember, I want one of those. That's not a battery. Okay, nail it is. You're getting nailed. I think they made Nailed as a 360 and PS3 game, like a shitty quad game. What a weird name. Oh, I wish I saved it for this room. This is one of the... I think possibly the exact room that killed me in the last video. See what I mean? These rooms seem like they're repeating an awful lot. And I've had it happen several times where I've gotten the exact same room, like, in the same floor. Did I just take two hits? Oh, no, it was something else. Come on, dude. Bow out. Just go. Thank you. Flies? Okay, I get an attack fly, so I've got a solar system of flies happening around me now. I guess that would make me the sun. And, yeah, son of God, I guess. I have the halo. Okay, well, I was about to say this is a good room, and then I take a hit. Holy shit, don't let this end it. This is too early. We gotta take this further. Oh! God fucking damn it. I'm stunned. Well, I didn't honestly expect that I would finish the whole thing right then, but I thought I could get a lot further since I had the nail. I had a plan, tried to put it into action, I did my best. If this is the last video, then thanks for joining me for this Let's Play. If it's not, then I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Later.